Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Shazwan Fikri bin Samsul Uzri. My matrix number 255496. Today, I will give a quick view for the impact of COVID-19 towards international trade. Alright, let's see. The coronavirus COVID-19 pandemic has spread from Wuhan in China across the globe and has affected the worldwide economy. The spread of this virus has encouraged social distancing, which led to the shutdown of business, financial markets, corporate offices, and events. There is a lot group of people have lost their job. Why? Because there is 600,000 job has been closed due to the pandemic. Okay? The major affected is restaurant, hotel business, and airplane business. Because the government has imposed stay-at-home policy and social distancing. Many countries that rely on imports are severely affected during this coronavirus epidemic, especially for the essential goods such as medicines, rice, sugar, and etc. This happened because many countries had partially and fully closed their borders and indirectly affect the trade finance, retail finance, and corporate finance.
And we have breaking news out of Malaysia. Malaysian Prime Minister Muhyiddin Yassin has announced a nationwide lockdown to curb the spread of COVID-19 in the country. It will take effect from Wednesday until the end of the month. Now, this comes after the number of cases in Malaysia surged past 500.
Keutamaan kerajaan kita pada masa ini adalah untuk mencegah penularan baru wabak ini yang dibimbangi akan menjangkiti lebih ramai rakyat. Situasi semasa wabak ini memerlukan tindakan drastik diambil bagi memulihkan keadaan secepat mungkin.
However, there are some trade finance facilities that boost up rapidly, such as letter of credit, LC, bankers acceptance, BA, and shipping guarantee, SG. During this pandemic. But now I want to explain about the most important and usable facility due to many countries ban any businesses activities, which is shipping guarantee. This crisis, pandemic, coronavirus. Many countries had shortage of medical machines, surgical masks, PPE uniform, and etc.
Untuk itu, saya telah mengumumkan peruntukan berjumlah RM500 million kepada Kementerian Kesihatan Malaysia. Dan bagi meningkatkan lagi keupayaan kementerian, kerajaan akan menyalurkan peruntukan tambahan sebanyak RM1 bilion bagi pembelian peralatan dan perkhidmatan untuk memerangi COVID-19, termasuklah mendapatkan
export import businesses has rise up due to the demand for essential goods and safety purposes. Although many countries have banned for any goods enter to their countries in the purpose of security, but they still need the medical supplies such as ventilator machine, surgical mask, glove, and also medicines to save nation's life. As we can see from the data, US is the highest COVID-19 cases. So, how they will save their people's life? So, shipping guarantee is the most suitable trade facilities for this pandemic to guarantee that the supplies will be distributed and received by the countries at specified period of time. Last but not least, we can save many people's life and global economy indirectly.